word reached me, first of all, that there would be one more X-Men movie and that I was involved in it, but it might not involve many other of the X-Men. I was intrigued, and then I learned a little more, and then I saw a script. Although that was, you know, like eavesdropping on the national security organization. And I was fascinated by what I heard. Then I read the script. And what had the biggest impact on me was reading the description of the setting for the first scene that Charles appears in, around about page 7 or 8 of the film. It was as far removed from the sedate intellectual world of Xavier's school for gifted children. And I was intrigued by that. And it led to a fascinating process of exploring what might happen to this man should his whole environment and his personal condition, both in terms of health and mental health and physical health, were to be transformed. Well, Charles would seem to be living in something that resembles an abandoned petrochemical factory in a massive oil tank which has fallen over on its side. And that's his home. Wearing stained pajamas and a nasty truckle bed and a little old black and white television set, far distance from his previous life. And he's unstable, vulnerable, weak, troubled, confused, and very dangerous. James Mangold has said that there are times when it looks like a $110 million little independent movie. And it does, and it feels like that too. And it felt like that for a great deal of the time that we were filming. Of course, there are action sequences, remarkable action sequences. It's full of adventure and tension, expectation. I know I had a great time. I was on the film for 8 weeks in the heat and humidity of Louisiana. And it was, every day was a new experience. I didn't feel as though I was shooting my seventh appearance in a superhero franchise. Well, the first time, no, I wasn't with you. I was with my wife and my agent, my team of agents. And but 4 days ago, I saw it sitting alongside Hugh at the Berlin Film Festival with a packed audience. And it was a very, very satisfying experience. I think the film is fine. I mean that not in the sense of it's just fine. I mean that it's exceptional. And I also had the feeling for the very first time that this is absolutely the most appropriate way to say goodbye. She is an extraordinary young woman, child, not a young woman. But she's one of those children that you say, well, she's 12 years old, going on 40. She is so wise and composed. And we also had a lot of fun. You know, Hugh and Daphne and I were trapped in that nasty old truck for days and days on end in these difficult conditions. And we had so much fun. We played games, we had quizzes, word games, puzzles. We sang songs to keep ourselves amused. She's a remarkable, whatever comes of her and her career, this one movie for her is really extraordinary.